Very good morning to one and all present here. First of all, I request all the non-speakers to keep their mic on mute. Let the speaker complete the session and we will have a separate question and answer round at last. So I, Abhishek Sharma, on behalf of Chaudhary Charan Singh National Institute of Agriculture Marketing, Jaipur, welcomes you all to the Kisan Mitra webinar series on agriculture technology for marketing. Organized by Chaudhary Charan Singh National Institute of Agriculture Marketing in partnership with Office of Principal Scientific Advisor, Government of India. TCS National Institute of Agriculture Marketing Jaipur is an autonomous organization established under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India, to cater various agriculture related aspects such as training, research, consultancy, education in agriculture marketing. TCS NIAM is also recognized globally as a center of excellence in Southeast Asia. Kisan Mitra Friends of Farmers is an initiative by Principal Scientific Advisor Office in partnership with CCS NIAM Jaipur. The objective of this initiative is to bring technologies to farmers and reverse migrants who have moved rural due to impact of COVID-19. Under this initiative, more than 1,000 technologies have been identified which are supported by ICAR institutions, NABARD, Ministry of Rural Development, ISRO and Gates Foundation. On the supply side of the technology, there are innovators, entrepreneurs, researchers in academic and research institutions talking about the technology, and webinar participants being on the demand side who are typically agribusiness companies, government functionaries, agribusiness companies and other agribusiness stakeholders who are keen in agri technologies. Moving further, I would like to introduce our today's speaker, Dr. G. Senthil Kumaran, who is working as a principal scientist at ICAR, Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. He has completed BE Agriculture degree from College of Agriculture Engineering, TNAU, Coimbatore in the year 1986. He obtained M.Tech degree in the Farm Machinery and Power from IIT Kharagpur in the year 1988 and PhD from TNAU Coimbatore in the year 2002. He joined Indian Council for Agriculture Research during 1989 and subsequently joined ICAR-IHR Bangalore in the year 1990. Since then, he has been working on mechanization of agriculture crops under institute projects and externally funded projects by ICAR, DST, NHB, NHM and RKVY. As a team member, he got awards like Dr. J.S. Kruthi Award, Kejriwal Award and IESAE Team Award. He was awarded RKJ Memorial Award by ISAE New Delhi for mechanizing mushroom sperm production. He has been involved in development of more than 35 horticultural machinery as a research team leader and member. These tools and machineries are adopted by farmers and industries in India and outside India. Private agriculture machinery manufacturers have also taken license to commercialize these machinery. He has also published several research papers in Indian and international journals and authored several book chapters. Now I would like to invite Dr. G. Senthil Kumaran to take a session on ICAR-IIHR horticulture tools and machinery. Over to you, doctor. Sir, please unmute your mic.
So good morning to all. Thank you so much for giving me the we have Indian Council of Agriculture Research, Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. And I would, I'm very happy. If I remember, I think somewhere in 2012-13, I was invited for mechanization Rajasthan, discussion of by Horticulture Department. I think it was conducted at CCS, Jaipur, if I am right. That is the connection I had with the Rajasthan and the horticulture mechanization. And it's nice that this institute is also doing the agriculture marketing and promoting agriculture marketing and then training the people in this line. Yeah, my presentation, of course, the I would like to tell you that the fabrication and supply of machinery and its repair and maintenance in the rural areas will be one more agricultural marketing or agricultural entrepreneurship development in the area of horticulture mechanization. As a probably this this information would be useful those who are looking forward to take up this agricultural mechanization or the horticulture mechanization, I mean production and supply and repair and maintenance of horticulture machinery. I think this information will be useful for them. So with this, what in India you can see that there are fruits, vegetable and plantation spices crops which are grown there are fruits, vegetable plantation and spices crops which are more than thousands, hundred thousands of hectares.
To interrupt you, you can share your PPT, sir. You can share your PPT.
It is shared. Okay, one second. I'm sorry. I thought it's shared. Okay. Is it visible?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Perfectly fine.
Yeah, fine. I was just telling about the horticulture crops which are grown more than 100,000 hectare in India. You can see the variety of horticulture crops. So what we would concentrate, or we had been concentrating on these crops, major crops, for which we have been developing tools and machinery to mechanize the different operations under these crops. So this is what our mandate of our crop, our institute under agriculture engineering discipline. So we have been working on that. I would like to tell that whatever the machinery, what we have developed at Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. All of you know that those who are in the horticulture and in agriculture also, the need of a planting material, whether it is a seed or seedling, a healthy and a more quantity of seeds and seedling production is a backbone of crop production. Unless otherwise the growers or the farmers, if they don't get the planting materials in time and the quality materials and of required quantity, then there is no. So, and of course, the nursery, whether it is a vegetable nursery or fruit nursery, all the operations are done manually. So, but due to that, the quantity is not met, and the journey to the laborers. So, for example, handling the sand, farmyard manure, soil for media preparation, and filling in the pro trays, the plastic trays, the cup trays, whatever you call it. So, filling manually, and planting or the putting the seed manually. So, all the cumbersome project or process. So what we have done is a series of machinery which can mechanize vegetable nursery and fruit nursery. The first thing is, the foremost thing is that many nursery still they are using sand, soil and farmer mixer. And some of the cocoa peat and vermicompost, these are all also people are using for the nursery production. But in that case, what we have done is that we have the first one, what you are seeing, this one is a for the larger nursery where they are handling tons of material. So this one, you can just feed the soil or sand or form your manure. It will be lifted to the cleaner air. Around it, and it will be rotating. Because of that, the clean material will come down to the mixer here, and then unwanted material will go as a waste. So under this mixture, it will be mixed and thoroughly, and from these chutes, one can, like, you know, by these manual laborers can sit here and then they can fill the bags, pro trays, other parts. And this one is a compact model where it's a for the smaller medium nursery growers. This also will do the same thing, like cleaning and mixing here, and then it will be mixed material will be elevated, and you can just fill these bags or pro trays here. And after filling the pro trays, you can have this model for dibbling and sowing these seeds, vegetable seeds, in the pro trays. This is the semi-automatic machine, and this is a complete automatic machine. What do we have this? So you just feed the pro trays here, and then this will step by step it will go and dibbling, vegetable seed sowing in the cavities, and then it comes out. This entire process will be done automatic. So all this machinery will be more useful for vegetable production. And advanced stage, the next step, we are all working on grafting of vegetable crops. That is, all of us know that grafting of fruit crops, but now our scientists, vegetable scientists, are working on grafting of vegetable crops to avoid or manage the soil-borne diseases by selecting a resistant rootstock and compatible cyan. So standardizing these two, some of the soil-borne diseases and the biotic stresses are managed by the grafted seedlings. So for that, we have been working on indigenously almost the final stage, and then we are in the process of preliminary trials, and it will be successful within 6 months or so. So this will mechanize the grafting process in. So when these are all for the seedling production. Now comes to the seed production. Of course, there are seed extractors for tomato, brinjal, and all those things as a commercially available. And we have developed a watermelon seed extraction. So the watermelon is cut into two halves, and then the pulp is scooped in this, and then there is a meshed, rollers are there, and which will separate the pulp and seed, and you can take out the seed. This is for seed production. Similarly, mushroom spawn, I think it will be more useful in the Rajasthan, because the Rajasthan, the spawn production and the mushroom production is very popular, and then people are consuming, and even the Punjab also, nearby states. And this mushroom also needs the spawn production, that is called the mushroom seed. So for the mushroom spawn production, of any variety for that matter, so the main thing is any grain, starchy grain. So this is cleaned here, and the clean grain is filled in this grain boiler. It's filled, and then hot water is filled. We use the solar hot water to save it. And this electrical heaters are switched on, and then the grain is boiled in this chamber. And once it is boiled, intermittently it can be stirred for uniform boiling, and it is tilted. The hot water is drained out after boiling, and then it is tilted to the mixer. The boiled grain is unloaded in the mixer. The mixer in this chamber, and then it is turned and unloaded in this chamber. From this chamber, you can fill the PP bags of 0.5 kg or 1 kg as per your requirement acts are fitted with the a ring, a neck ring of PP rings or the PVC rings and the cotton plugs and the mouth, and it goes for sterilization. So the sterilization, again, we have a completely standardized for mushroom spawn production, especially designed and developed. And we also integrated this with the solar hot water system. And this is after sterilization, it goes for inoculation. So we have a small inoculating tool, and the laminar flow, it can be kept. The sterilized packs can be inoculated by using the mother spawn. So this is inoculate. These set of machinery are very useful for mechanizing the mushroom spawn production. We have almost mechanized around 26 laboratories in the country, almost. Where spawn production machinery are for production of spawn production, either it is in the government side or in the private side. And similarly, wherever the rural areas, wherever the sterilization is the problem because of the availability of electricity, so we have modified, and then we have provided with the multi-fuel boiler system where the steam can be put inside the sterilizer, the autoclave, for sterilizing the paddy straw or the spawn. So this is multi-fuel autoclave system. And for the production, to make it very sustainable and then, you know, more adaptable, we have designed and developed a solar powered a chamber in which you can keep your ready to fruit bag bags, like after inoculating the spawn in the sterilized paddy straw, that can be kept here, and this can be used by any your backyard or the terrace. And this has a gunny bags all around and the insect screen inside, so that the insect will not go inside. And these gunny bags are wetted either by manually or spraying automatic at the spraying with a timer based spraying system, so that this gunny bag is always wet to provide the temperature and humidity for cultivation of mushroom. So this unit, these are the units, you know, you can suggest for the rural adoption, whereas the rural women and the rural establish in their backyard and start cultivating the mushroom. And this, the bags can be supplied in the form of ready to fruit bag, whereas this chop kit, I mean the paddy straw, is cut, sterilized and inoculated using the spawn. And after spawn running, these bags are given for cultivation. That is called ready to fruit bags technology. So if you supply to the rural people, they can just use this structure and produce at least a kg per day, so that they can sustain just by getting, you know, 100 rupees or so every day. So this entire system for spawn production and cultivation of mushroom, this will be more useful in Rajasthan and Haryana and neighboring states. When it comes to transplanting, vegetable transplanting, we have a semi-mechanized transplanting system where this tractor operated bed farmer come transplanter makes the broad bed, and then the wheels make the cavity on the broad bed, and the protrays are with the ceilings are kept here. And then operator, those who are sitting at the back, they can just take the seedling and drop in the cavities. So it is a kind of a semi-mechanical or semi-manual transplanter for vegetable transplanting. And you can see this, this is a tree drill where in the fruit crops, the trees around, say 2 meters around in a circle, fertilizer are spread at a 9-inch depth in the soil, so that the root zone gets the proper nutrition through fertilizer. For that, we have developed a fertility where... Yes, sir.
There is an echo in... Some disturbance echo. Coming, sir. Yes, now it is stopped, sir. Now again it is started, sir.
That beep sound, is it?
Yeah, it's a beep. Some kind of beep is...
Yeah, is this okay?
No, it's not.
Yeah,
it's okay. Fine, UPA, sir.
My UPS, I switched off. Is useful to apply the fertilizer around the tree crops at 2 meter circle and 9-inch depth. So this will be useful for the orchard. Similarly, for another orchard management system, we have developed a tractor hydraulically operated platform. This platform can be fixed on a tractor trailer, and then there are hydraulic system which can be connected to the tractor hydraulic system. The operator can operate from the top, so this can go at 6 meter height of maximum, and at any height it can be stopped by operating the hydraulic lever, and this will be used for spraying, keeping the spraying system at the bottom, and you can cover the canopy very uniformly of orchard in the tree crops, and you can spray any tree in the orchard. And similarly, you can do the pruning operation for fruit crops by using the engine operated pruners. You can just do the pruning, and also harvesting of mangoes by giving the spreading the net at the bottom. You can do the fruit harvesting also. So this tractor hydraulic operated platform is useful for spraying, pruning, and harvesting in fruit crops. And we have small tools harvesting mango. So you can see this ring with a net for collection of fruits, and it is connected to a pole, long pole, where you can just lift the this harvester and position the mango here, and the pedicel is cut by this blade, and you can collect the harvested mangoes in the net. Similarly, you can see the tool harvester for and for, say, we tried for guava and pomegranate and all those things, a short to height crops. And this will be used for that, round fruits. And where the thorny fruits, crop like lemon, a lime, we have modified with the PVC pipe for collecting the fruits, where it's a plucked fruit can be collected in the PVC tubes, maybe 1 or 1.5 kg, and it can be unloaded, and it can hold, say, 1 or 2 kg, and then you can keep harvesting your lime, lemon in this, using this tool, and it can also be used for your amla in your area. So this will be useful for harvesting a smaller round fruit. And wherever the onion production is very popular, say like Maharashtra, Karnataka, and some parts of northern India, where your onion production is there, we have a completely mechanized all the operations of onion cultivation, except onion seedling transplanting. That we are also working on it, but it is a cumbersome project. But other than that, we have a onion seed extracted from the dried onion ambles. You can thrash the amble flowers, and then you can extract the onion seed from your onion flowers. The extracted seed, it is for directly sowing in the rain-fed crop or irrigated crop. There is no problem. So wherever the direct sowing of onion is taken up, this is useful. It is a simple ground wheel is there. There is a shaft on which there are plastic boxes or metal boxes, and series of metal boxes or plastic boxes are kept on the boxes. There are holes, like, you know, on the surface there are holes. Inside the box you fill the seed, and by rotating this wheel, and if you pull it while rotating, the box will spread the seed uniformly in this field, and the chain or the rollers will cover the soil after sowing. So this will ensure a uniform distribution of seeds in recommended 1 square meter. For example, in one square meter, if you want 120, 150 seedling crop standing, then you can achieve through this. It is very simple. Similar kind of mechanism, that seeder can be pulled or operated by. So these three mode of power we are using, and we have developed onion direct sowing seeders. After seeing, we have tractor operated onion digger, and it's a modified version of a potato digger look like. And the blades and the chain system and the windowing system is modified for digging the onion and put it in the field for curing. So what happens after harvesting the onion with leaves are left in the field for curing. Once it is cured, that means the leaves are dried, and there is a process called cutting the leaves to take the bulbs. That is called detopping. So that we have mechanized. It's a first of its kind in India, and where you can just feed the cured harvested onions with the leaves, and the leaves are cut and then bulb, you know, bagged for further marketing. This is also a very useful machinery for detopping. And this is a manually operated rose onion grader. Rose onion is the very popular in Karnataka. It's a smaller onion than the, you know, bigger onion. And this has a perforated sheets, and by oscillating that, you can just grade the onion in three grades, smaller, and then medium, and then larger. And similarly for the bigger onions, this is a rolling drum with the smaller gap, medium gap, and the larger gap. Once you feed the onions, medium-sized onions and the larger onions can be graded based on the size, so that it can get a premium price. The graded onions can get a premium price. When it this is for so far production and the on-farm processing. Now we have done a smaller work on the processing of horticulture crops, especially for bulb breaking of garlic. See, garlic bulbs can be put inside, and then it can be broken, and then the cloves are separated, and the cloves also can be used for planting as well as for processing, say, pickle or paste making of garlic. And this is garlic bulb breaker cum peeler, which will peel the skin from the garlic cloves. And this is the pomegranate arid extractor. You split the pomegranate, you put it in the machine, and by rotary action and especially design the cushioned drums, and with a typical wavery movement of the pomegranate, arils are get separated, and it can be collected in this, and then peel will come out in the chute. So this will be used for direct consumption as well as juice making. And this is for raw jackfruit, where the jackfruit is used for the vegetable purpose. The outside skin can be peeled through this. And this is for a vegetable dicing stool, where, you know, smaller catering hotels and all, you know, they can use it for dicing and some of the carrots and radish and all. It can be used for dicing the vegetables. There are two items which I will be, you know, introducing to this group where you can think of adopting. Already, Karnal, Haryana, such vans are running. So you can just visit and then have a thought of adopting under horticulture schemes, or you can promote to the growers in your area. This is a solar powered fruits and vegetable vending system where this chamber is completely solar powered, and the base vehicle is Tata Ace here. You can have such a medium sized vehicle, Mahindra or Ashok Leyland, or even the Tata Ace itself, the next Intra model is there. So such vehicles can be used without, you know, the building. The on the chassis, this is constructed. This we have designed so that you can keep the fruits and vegetables in the rack system with the crates, and at the back side you can have the and audio system. It can be used for your advertisement, and it has a system for monitoring your movement of the vehicle. It has the evaporatively very strong cooling system to keep the fruits and vegetables fresh for 36 to 48 hours. So that suppose today afternoon or evening, you can sell it in a fresh condition. That's what this is, the standardized evaporative cooling system what we have introduced, and it has a digital balance and mic system and video system and GPS system and lights for night vending. All these electrical gadgets are run through solar the solar panels on the top, and then these controllers and then charger and the batteries, all the electrical gadgets can run through solar operation, solar power. And this will be more useful, especially in this COVID time. Karnataka, around 10 districts, they have used this vans and then delivered the fruits and vegetables to the customers at the doorsteps in a fresh and clean and hygiene condition during the COVID. It has done. And then Haryana in Karnal, they have also adopted to manage the distribution of fruits and vegetables during the COVID season. So this is more helpful for produce handling and door-to-door or maybe layout and apartment selling of fruits and vegetables in a hygienic and fresh conditions. In the similar path, so we thought of giving a smaller version to the pushcart vendors, where, you know, they can adopt this for fruits and vegetables in the nook and corner of all the this, whether rural or city area. So you have, it is a pushcart has a, you know, a problem of, you know, the pushing and the drudgery, and also it is always not hygienic, like, you know, dust and pollution is on the, all the produce and collected. So hence what we thought, that it has a chamber with the arrangement of crates and with the digital balance and announcement mic system, is filled with the humidity by a standardized solar, I mean the evaporative cooling system, by the pumping and the filtered water. And the vehicle is a motor which is operating and driving this rear wheel, and the battery is there to store from the solar power collected from these panels. So this entire system is solar powered. The person need not to pedal it. It's a simple, it just give the accelerator. It will run with a slow speed, and it can go around say 50-60 kilometer in and around by one charging. And if charge is gone by chance, then you can also manually pedal it and then bring the vehicle slowly to your destination. And this has 20 crates, roughly 200 kg of, you know, fruits and vegetables can be stored. And they can, you know, they can go to a mandi or a farmer's collection center where they can just load and enter crates with the different types of vegetables and fruits, and then just raise the accelerator and then go to your destination where you can just park it, whether it can be a rural area or the apartment, where you just announce it through the mic system, and then customer can come and then they can just select it, weigh and sell it. So this is a system that we have introduced. Around 15 such cycles we have given to CSP program. And such a introduction can be thought of in the states, and wherever whomsoever is attending in the respective states, these two things can be introduced to handle fresh produce of fruits and vegetables in a hygienic and clean and fresh manner to doorsteps of the customers. Similarly, in the similar line, we have also conceived the idea of taking the fruiting mushroom bags to the doorsteps where the customer can pluck their desired fruit, I mean, mushrooms, and then just weigh and purchase it. The system is same, and it has a solar powered tricycle, and this chamber is holding the mushroom growing bags, and this system will give you the humidity and the cleanness, and the customer can just come and select their fresh mushroom and buy and go. And even this will avoid the post-harvest losses of plucked mushroom. Normally they can pack it and sell it in the push cart. So even if it is not sold today, it can be sold, you know, fresh next day. So, and then this has a consumer satisfaction where the people can see the mushroom, get convinced and pluck of their choice and then purchase. So these are some of the, you know, produce handling system which we have recently introduced. And you can just see how the ICRIHR machinery has spread or adopted in the various states of the country. And yes, your Rajasthan is yet to enter. Probably by this presentation, some of the officers and the decision makers can introduce the IHR machinery through Rajasthan. We participated earlier in the Rajasthan Horticulture Mela, what that called, and we have presented this thing to a minister who came some few years back, 4 or 5 years back to Bangalore. And there was the procedure we have been adopting to introduce IHR machinery and help the mechanization of horticulture in the states. Somehow we take it up, and probably this presentation and this group may help us in disseminating our technology in the state of Rajasthan. Thank you so much. This is what I wanted to give you, the tools and machinery developed as IIHR for mechanizing horticulture. Yes, sir. Any questions, sir?
Thank you, Dr. Jim. I request all the participants to raise their questions one by one, or you can also write your questions in the chat box. Again, I request all the participants to raise your questions. You can also write your questions in the chat box provided.
Who are all the participants, by the way? Like,
sir, it's a mixed group, and the whole whatever the video is also live on the Facebook of Niyam Agri Business Incubator as well. So people can also see your presentation live from the Facebook as well.
Okay.
And, one question came, sir. How farmers? One second.
Yeah.
Farmers will get these instruments.
Yeah. So see, the we have authorized manufacturers, those who have taken the design license for commercialization of this machinery. Those manufacturers list can be given by us, and growers or the government agencies can purchase from them at their convenience. There is no problem. And to help the government agencies, all the states is almost the government agencies. IHR also helps in supplying guidance in mechanization and supply the machinery. This is how it can be. And also the entrepreneurs or the FPOs, those who are attending and seeing this, you can also take the technology or taking the design. So for example, the van, which I was talking about, the fruits and vegetable vending van, was taken up by a startup, and they have supplied five vans in the state of Haryana under the subsidy scheme. And there are, I think, if I'm right, another 15 are to be supplied to the different farmers. So there are opportunities. They can take up this as an entrepreneurship of, taking this technology, design, improve, and fabricate and supply to the entrepreneurs, the states, and the growers. And this will be opportunity. Not only IHR machinery, in general, horticulture machinery, you can collect and then select the machinery and take the from the various institutes and this, and then sign the MOU, and officially you can commercialize these machinery. Thank you. Yeah, and then if for the department officials and the decision makers and the policy makers, those who are attending this IHR, the premier institute, you are going to have a series of lectures in the different aspects of fruits, vegetables also. And probably you can all sign MOU from the different states. Of course, the few states, they have signed MOU with ICR, IHR. And other government departments, you can visit. And we will be having a National Horticulture Fair in the month of February, if possible, physically or virtually, whatever it is. And last year, the the principal secretary from Haryana, Madam, was visited and immediately taken the decision of the technology adoption in the state of Haryana. So similarly, from Telangana, secretary came and they also adopted. So likewise, I think by visiting ICR, IHR, you will understand the technologies which can be adopted for the growers and the entrepreneurship development, and then, all the groups of horticulture. So that will be a platform where the interaction and the knowledge accumulation, so that all the technologies of ICR, IHR can be disseminated through your agencies, departments, and the contacts. That's what our request, and we are here to help you. Yeah, kiwi sir, fruit is not. Yeah, got it. So kiwi fruit is not our mandate crop because we are in the south. CIFET, Ludhiana, Central Institute of Post-Harvest Engineering and Technology, Ludhiana, Punjab, may be contacted. They have a station at Dabor, probably. They must have. Are you talking about the kiwi harvesting? Or what is that? I'm not, I'll just check it. Machinery required, mechanization of kiwi fruits. Yeah, the tools, harvesting tools, which I was just showing, I think some of the tools you can just modify to harvest the kiwi fruits. And processing, yes, processing and all, we are not working on it. I mean, it's not our mandate crop. You can contact Central Institute of Post Harvest Engineering Technology, Ludhiana, or any other horticultural universities or agriculture universities in that area, maybe Jammu and Kashmir or Himachal. You can give my phone number also, 944.
Sharing the email ID. Yeah, I have the number, sir. I will share the number with you. I will share the number as well. I'm sharing the email ID. If a particular person has any question, then he will definitely.
No, it is confusing. You just type only Central Government G. That's all. I mean, not because it's confusing actually. Yeah, this and phone number is 944.
I have it. I have it, sir. I will. I'm just texting.
Yeah, sir. Yeah.
So, if any participant wants to contact personally with Dr. G. Senthil Kumaran, he can directly send an email, or he can give a call to him. And if you have any other questions also, we can take up the questions. We have some time.
This is my WhatsApp number. In case you would like to have, you know, you can send the pictures or how to do, what to do. Those things also can be, you know, sent and then discussed.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Presentation has also provided deep insights. Many thanks for sharing your invaluable experience in agriculture technology, and participants really got the benefit from your talk. And we have, as discussed, we have also live your presentation on the Facebook, so might be the participants from there also can view it later and get the live presentation of you and get the insights. So at last, I would like to thank everyone for sparing their valuable time with us. And our next presentation will be on Thursday, 15th of October, 2020. Thank you.
Yeah, I will send you the brochure on the machinery, our machinery, so that whomsoever wants, you know, you can share it. Huh? The same mail ID, I will send you that. Okay.
Perfect.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah.